Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam sejahtera
brother,
buat kita semua.
Non-Muslim? Are you a non-Muslim?
Yes, I'm Christian.
Okay, what's the good name, brother?
Yeah. My name is Bona.
Sorry?
Bona.
Bona.
Yeah.
Okay, brother, what's your question?
And I'm a student in university. And my question is, the name of Allah, it's come from Arab. And Allah, or Elohim, or Eloi, it's come from Hebrews, or Jews. So, Jews and also Hebrews and also Arab, they are still family. And they have same family language. So, I think all of religion in this world and all of the country have their own name to our Creator in the heaven, as we call in Christian Father. So why all of country have to fight just because of naming problem? I think this is just because of naming problem. Because all of religion and all of country have their own name to our Creator. Thank you. And maybe for the next, why human have to give name to our Creator? Why we have to give a name?
The brother asked the question that in Arabic we say Allah, in Hebrew we say Allah. Why do we have to fight over it? Why human beings have to give name to our Creator?
Yeah, because we are too small to give a name to our Creator. We are too small, I think.
Brother, do you have a name?
Sorry, mister?
Do you have a name?
My name?
Yes.
Yes, my name Bona.
Why do you have a name?
Sorry?
Why do you have a name?
Because my parents gave me a name. So the people know me.
If they have to call you, how will they call you?
Bona.
Yes, same.
All of people
if you want
call,
to call
me
our Creator,
Bona.
The Creator should have a name. If you don't give name to a Creator, how will you call him? Coming to your question. In Arabic, okay. We say Allah. In Hebrew, we say Allah. Why do we fight? I do agree with you. We should not fight over naming Almighty God. And in my lecture, I told you very clearly, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 110, Allah says, قُلْ إِذُ اللَّهِ أَبِذُ الرَّحْمَانِ أَيَّ مَا تَدُوا فَلَوَ الْأَسْمَى الْحُسْنَى. Say, call upon him by Allah or by Rahman, by whichever name you call upon him. To him belongs the most beautiful name. You can call Allah by any name, but it should be a beautiful name. It should be a name he has given himself. We cannot give our own name to Allah, because you rightly said he is superior. Who are we to give a name to Allah? That's the reason we call Allah by the name Allah has given himself. Like in the Quran, there are various attributes given to Allah: Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Hakim, most merciful, most gracious, most wise. He has given. Who are we to give him? You're perfectly right. So these are the names given by Allah in the glorious Quran.
So, mister,
this glorious Quran is the last and final revelation of Almighty God, which was revealed to the last and final revelation for the whole of humankind. So Almighty God himself has given this name. If you and I give, I know we can make a mistake. Same way you asking the name given as Father.
Yeah, in Christian we call Father.
In Christian you say Father. In Quran, the Arabic word for Father is Ab. It's very easy. But Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purposely did not use this word Ab, because it was misunderstood. Otherwise the word is good. But the Christian starting misunderstanding that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is the begotten son. Otherwise, you know, when I say to a child, son, come here, no problem. But if I tell my begotten son, come here, if I tell that to a 30-year-old boy, maybe he'll punch me. He will say, you're insinuating. Begotten son means you have sex with someone and then the son is born. So how can you use this word for Almighty God? You're belittling him. So that's the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the last and final revelation did not use the word Ab, but he used the word Rab, sustainer, cherisher. So because this word was misunderstood, Almighty God in the last revelation did not use this word Ab, that is father, but used the word Rab, that is sustainer. And all the attributes given in the Quran are given by Allah himself, 100%. So can make mistakes. That's the reason there are 99 attributes given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, and the crowning one is Allah, which I described in my lecture. Hope that answers the question, brother.
Thank you. But as entomology, if we can see as entomology, I think all of people have misunderstanding about the meaning of word God and also Elohim, Eloi, or Allah. Because as if we can see the word of God, it's come from German. That meaning is
brother, to in, but in my lecture, I clearly told you we prefer calling Allah by the Arabic word Allah instead the English word God. Now you're telling me terminology of God. We don't agree God is the correct word because you can play mischief with God. If you add S to God, it becomes gods. If you add D-E-S-S to God, it becomes goddess. And with the reason, I prefer calling with the Arabic word Allah, which cannot be manipulated. Hope that answers the question, brother.
Can we why brother, the Muslim have to make a war to Christian and also Jews? Why Muslim have to make a war?
Why Muslims have to make a war?
Yeah, as we can see in this word, Muslim always make a war to Christian because just naming problem. When we say Jesus, brother, the Muslim is also...
Brother, you ask the question. Now, don't give a lecture here. You ask the question, why do Muslims make a war with the Christian?
Yeah, correct? And also Jews.
Muslims are making war or Christians are making war with the Muslims? Huh? You look around in the world. America is attacking Afghanistan. America and England are sending armies to Iraq. Weapons of mass destruction. It is not found. That means you don't know the news. According to Chilcot report, George Bush, who was the previous president of USA, and Tony Blair, who was the previous president of UK, they are responsible for killing hundreds of thousands of Iraqi.
Islam is now revenge?
Listen to the answer, brother. Sir. Your question is over, correct?
Okay.
Now you listen and don't speak.
Okay, mister. Thank you.
You're asking me, keeping on talking, not listening. You are saying Muslims are making war with the Christians. It is the Christian which is making a war with the Muslims. They are attacking everywhere in the name of war for peace. They are not doing war for peace. They are doing war on peace. You see my lecture, Media and Islam, War or Peace. Today, according to Chilcot report, a report taken out by UK, that George Bush and Tony Blair are responsible for killing of hundreds of Muslim Iraqis.
So Islam is
revenge. They told a lie that there were weapons of mass destruction. They told a lie. There are no weapons of mass destruction. Today what's happening? They are entering Syria. They are interested in taking control of the oil wells. I tell these Christians, you leave us Muslims alone. If you don't like us, no problem. You leave us alone. Why are you interfering with the Muslims? Today, Islam, 25% of the world population, more than 1.8 billion of the human being, they are Muslim. If you look at the Crusades, there were tens and hundreds of thousands of human beings killed because they did not accept Christianity. Do you know that? I'm asking you the question, which Muslim army came to Indonesia? Today Indonesia has 88% Muslims. which army came to Indonesia, brother? Which army came to Indonesia, brother? Give me the reply.
Sorry?
Brother, give me the reply. Which army came to Indonesia? Which army?
Netherlands and United Kingdom.
Ah, were they Muslims? Sorry? Were they Muslims? They were Christians. Today, Indonesia, 88% of the Indonesians, they are Muslims. The largest country which has the maximum number of Muslims is Indonesia. Which Muslim army came here? So you find out that the Christians were responsible for forcing down their religion. It's a misconception about the sword of Islam, which my son clarified. So go back and read history. You'll come to know that Islam is a religion of peace, and we are peaceful people, and we spread the message of peace. Hope that answers the question.